Hi there, this is Kevin once again and welcome to our part 2 of our Python Django with Google Firebase series. So let's see how we will go through it. And here we will be covering our Firebase invalid credentials alert, requesting session in sign in, and at last we will see how we will go to the sign up form for Firebase authentication. So let's see. So guys, currently what we have done is, if you see here, we have created a simple sign in form in which if you type a password, here we will directly get login. But guys, here the one of the issue here is, though it's working fine, but if the issue here is, suppose if I type a wrong password, something wrong password wrong me, it shows the invalid password and bad request for URL. And guys, it's very creepy to see this screen. And here, if someone can see our code also, here he will get the information of our code. So here we just need to get a alert of invalid credentials in place of this error. So here, for fixing this error of invalid credentials and we are getting this error screen, we need to do some minor changes. And guys, before doing these changes, I need to do some changes which I got in the suggestions in the comment box. Here what I have done is, I have just do some minor changes. That is, here I spelled wrong with sign in, so I need to change it here, and the url.py also, and here I need to put here. And other mistake that I have done is, actually in the welcome.html there is no use of CRF token here. CRF token is only used when there is any form here, and there we are not using any form here, so that's why there is no use of CRF token in welcome.html. so that are the issues, and thank you for your immense feedback in the comment box. And let's see, and now we'll go through. And guys, here for invalid credentials alert, what we need to do, we need to put a try accept block here, and here I'll put tap for identification issue, and here I expect, and in expect what we will do, guys, here I just put a message, make a variable and put a message, and this message will be show in pop-up, and here it will be invalid credentials. So that's the simple message that will be returned in the pop-up. And here what we'll do, if the condition is true, then this welcome.html template will run. But if the condition is not true, then here it will show the pop-up message on the same template. The template is signin.html, the sign-in form here. And here what we'll do, here we will return the same template, and the template will be render function will be used, and the request, then here I will type the template name, and the template name is, so the template is this. So I just copy the name here and paste it here. So signin.html, and here in the dictionary form here I need to put that, I will type MeWS message, and here I will type MeWSAG. So that's done. So guys, after putting this try and accept block in our views.py, I need to do some minor changes in our signin.html for getting that pop-up by using JavaScript script alert function. So for that, here is our signin.html, and here I'll be using if condition. And guys, if you know, for using any Python code in our Django, we directly in HTML file, we directly need to use double percentage sign, and we'll use our Python code directly. So here I'll be typing our using of this variable. So let me copy this variable from here and just put it here directly. So this it will check for the this condition will check if there is something in this message variable, then it will show the alert pop-up alert. So here I will type and if. So that's it, and in this I need to use simple JavaScript. So script, and I will close it, and here I will using alert function. So in the alert I'll be using passing this invalid credential message directly. So here, for using this any pass variable in template, we need to put it in our curly braces. So these are the done changes, and let's see whether it's working or not. So I'll open our, so here I'll be typing some like wrong email, and is the wrong password. So it's redirecting but not showing any alerts. So I need to check So there is an issue in the alert function. I need to put comma, that's why I think it's not working. And let's check it out. And I just put change, do this change, and here if I again do this home page, and I will put wrong email, and let's check it out. So that's guide, it shows invalid credentials. I'll click on OK, and if I'll again type any right email like this, and I'll type the password 123456, that's my password. And if I'll sign in, so I'm just getting welcome.html. But if I'll be again going to this page and again typing something wrong at the gmail.com with some wrong password, it's showing me an invalid credential. So that's a simple BAM guys, and now let's check how will we request a session in sign in page, because every time you get sign in, then there should be a session to maintain the user ID, and that user ID will be used in our whole code. So let's see. So guys, for getting a session, first of all I will tell you, wait, here is my views.py, directly open my views.py, and guys, in this views.py there is a user here. And if you can see it, this is a user variable used for sign in with email and password. And here you can see, before I use this to print this user. So let's check in our terminal what we are getting in this user variable. And if you can see, while I tried it, so this is the actually the user is this, but that thing that I am printing. So this is a user. And guys, in this user here, for requesting a session, what you can use is, here you can see, here is a local ID. This is the ID of user ID, and this is the ID of the user which is login. Either you can use this ID, or if you don't want to use this, you can use this ID token. This ID token is for for using session. But I'm in my previous projects, I've worked with local ID, because with the help of this local ID, you can also use this local ID in the database and for retrieving the user information. It's your choice. Either you can use local ID, or you can use this ID token. You can use any one of the thing, but here I will use ID token. If you want, you can use local ID also. So I'll just copy this local ID. So I just copied it, and here we are doing requesting session for sign in in Firebase. And currently in this print user, if I will directly put that ID token here, let's check whether we are only getting this ID token or not. So here again I'll move it, sorry guys, yeah. So if I go again back, and here I'll type password 123456, I'll sign in and welcome, and here let's see. So you can see, only the thing I am getting this is this ID token. So I'll be using this ID token for requesting session. And for requesting session is not a big deal, it's just easy. So I will typing session underscore ID equal to user, and that ID token that I have used it. So this is the session ID that will be used. And requesting session is easy, directly request dot SESS request of session. Here we can put the name of the session. So I'll just put UID and equal to, here we need to convert this session ID into string. So that way I'll be using str here, and str I will directly using session ID here. So that's it, we have requested a session. And guys, if we request a session, then other thing we need to do is, we need to put the logout. And we will be using logout in this welcome.html here at the right corner. We will be using logout button here. So let's do it. First of all, we will create a function for logout, and the function name will be logout only, and logout. So here we'll be using request. And guys, if you are having any query or any suggestion, please comment out, because your support is one of the important thing for which I am creating this tutorial. And guys, here I'll be using logout. And guys, before logout, for logout we will be using a library that is in our Django. So I think the library is from django.contrib. I need to import auth here. So that's it. And guys, for that, if we use it this auth variable, then I have to change this auth here. So that otherwise they will get clash. So I'll just use auth here. So that's it. And here in this, here I need to put auth dot logout, and here I need to put request. So that's it. And other thing, I need to return to the same template, that is the signin.html homepage over, for so that it can sign into the other user. So a return and then render, sorry, return and render. Here I'll be using request, and then I'll be using the name of the file HTML where it will get redirect. So that's it. So this logout button will, this logout function will redirect to logout. And the other, first of all, I need to create a logout button in this welcome.html. So I'll be creating a logout button, and for that logout button I also need to create some CSS. First of all, I will create a logout button only. So I'll type button type equal to button. So that's a, and here I'll be using a button logout. So let's check first of all whether we are getting this logout. Logout logout. So it's my logout button, and let's check whether we are getting this logout button or not. So I click on continue, and here we'll get this logout button. So first of all, let's put this logout button at the right corner of the screen. So I'll be using some CSS here. So I'll just put div tag here, and div, so div, and using this div here, and I need to put this little welcome behind this div. So that's it. And here in the style tag, I need to make a style tag. So I'll just using some basic CSS. So here I'll be using div, and in div I can put 5px here. So that's it. Let's check whether we got our button at the right corner or not. So I'll again click continue. So I got this logout button at the right corner. Now I need to put this logout button to with some that specific function so that it will redirect to our sign in page. So for that, what I need to do here, I need to put the login on click function. So I'll put on click, and on click, what it will do here, it will redirect to the URL. So first of all, I need to create a URL in url.py. So is the url.py. Here I need to put the URL for logout. So URL, and then here I'll put comma chevron for starting of function, and the name will be logout symbol. And that's it, I think. Yeah. And guys, one thing I need to do here is, first of all, I need to put I need to put reviews dot the function name is logout, and I need to remove this. And guys, here I need to put the name of the function also, because this name will be used in our on click function, otherwise I will not able to use it. So that's a log here, and in our welcome.html here, in this on click, I need to put location.href, and location.href, and here I need to put this percentage sign, and I again tend this percentage sign is used for using some Python code in, and then I need to put the name is log. So what it is doing, actually it is a syntax for using some URL with the name in Django. And I covered it in our previous Python Django series. If you don't know what I am doing, you can see there. So that's a simple trick. And here we can use any, you call any URL by its name only. So guys, before that, we need to put the, before checking, we need to put the commas here so that we can separate it out. And actually I need to put the one comma here. So that's it. Let's see whether our logout button is working or not. So I'll just click on continue here, and let's see whether it's, so that's a bam guys, our logout button is also working. I will again show you, if I'll put this sign in, it show login credentials, and with login credentials, if I put the right password 123456, I'll click on sign in. So that's welcome at gmail.com logout. So it's working fine. So here we have done with sign in alert, requesting session, logout button. So all it's done. Now we will see how to create a sign up form.